Today, it's game day in Orono. The home opener, quarterback Chris Ferguson and the Maine Black Bears are hunting for their first win of the season. The high-scoring Bryant Bulldogs look to make their new head coach 2-0. Maine Bryant on the Black Bears Sports Network is next.
Guy who's really composed, great football player. Maine's excited about this guy.
And he's throwing right off the bat, and he's looking downfield, has a man. Jared Azuma's got it at the 30, still going to the 21-yard line. Huge first down pickup.
And here's what I'm talking about. Chris Ferguson sitting in the pocket. He's got pressure in his face.
Ferguson looking over the middle. He has Edwards. Edwards inside the 10, going for 6. He's in.
Dan, that's what we were missing last week, man. Getting Edwards involved more into the play, into the play calls. Just a dynamic player. We saw it all year last year, this freshman year. Just a really dynamic player, a guy that makes a lot of things happen.
Wilson looking downfield. Puts it up in the air on the coverage. The Black Bears unable to come down with it. Who came down with it? Two players wrestling for the ball.
They gave it to Bryant. That was a jump ball right there.
And so we got a 3rd and 1. No gain on that one. Another handoff. Another reverse. Sewell drops the ball. Recovered by Maine. That's Charles Mitchell who comes up with it. Bryant turns it over.
Great job by Charles Mitchell. Bryant tries to run the same play they ran a couple plays earlier that they got 9 yards on.
By the turnover, ball's at the 38. Rolling out is Ferguson. Throws downfield. Has a man. It's caught. That is Dunn. Julian Dunn gets behind the secondary for a big first down pickup.
See this little woody boot play?
Ferguson fakes. Looking downfield again. Has a man juggled. And is it a touchdown? It is. Ernest Edwards was juggling it all the way into the end zone.
Fantastic. You can just see Ferguson in the pocket. He's just so calm, so collected.
Last year. So 3rd and 10 now for Bryce Wilson and the Bulldogs. And he's throwing and he's under pressure. He's spun around. Now hit and dropped. Jerron Greyer got him. Spoken like
fun.
A true big man.
I'm excited.
All right, and it is going to be a handoff to another big man, Josh Mack. Lots of room on the outside. Mack still going. Mack, 40, 35, and finally taken down. As the Black Bears ready to go on 2nd and 10. Handoff again to Mack. This time he breaks into the secondary. Mack is going to beat them all. Touchdown, Black Bears.
What a fantastic run by Mack. Great blocking up front. That's what Maine needed. Great play.
A 66-yard run for Josh Mack. And the Black Bears lead it 20-3. I told you about the game he had against Bryant last year, 159 yards and 3 touchdowns. Here's Kenny Delcon for the point after, and that one's blocked, and that's going to be run back by Bryant. Torrey Dixon is going to take it all the way, and they'll get 2 points out of that. And he's looking to throw. Maine coming after him. Pump fake. He's hit, and that one's going to be picked off. Darius Hart. Hart still going. Hart going for the end zone. He's in.
Great job. Starts up front with Dakota Tarbox and the pressure in the face of Wilson. Gets the pressure. Hart's right there to make a play. A great return.
So 2nd and 10 now at the 14. Running is Wilson. He takes a big hit and goes down. Now the ball loose. It's going to be Black Bear ball.
Great play. Bubba just smokes him.
Here is Mack now on the pitch. Mack cuts it up. Mack still going, falling, and he is in. Touchdown, Black Bears. 13 yards just like that. Maine's got another one. He's going to get it again. Going right up the middle. And there he goes. A 60-yard touchdown run for Josh Mack. Third of the game.
Dan, I think it's safe to say this is going to be your CAA Player of the Week right here. This was fantastic.
And with that one, they will celebrate the victory. Joe Harris-Simiak. And the Black Bears pick up win number one on the season. They take the home opener here in big fashion, 60-12. 60-12, the final score. Let's find out how happy Joe Harris-Simiak is. He's down with John Alba.
Joe, the most dominating win in your tenure as head coach. What does this prove to you about your team?
Yeah, I think it's just first and foremost the way we responded from a tough loss. I think the guys stayed focused all week, and we just talked about taking care of us. And hopefully this just propels us forward. You know, we got the bye week coming up, and then we play the number one team in the country. So I just like the way our guys responded and stayed focused the whole game.
I was just about to bring that up. You have the bye week. Then you've got James Madison. You've got UCF on that slate, Villanova. How big was a statement win like today for you guys?
It was good. I think the kids got to realize that we're good enough to win. You know, I think last week was such a tough loss, and this is this first season that this team is together. So it's the first win for them. Gives us confidence. We just got to keep believing in what we're doing. And ultimately, we got a tough stretch ahead, but these guys got to have a great week of practice next week.
Joe, thank you so much for your time. Let's send it back to Dan and the Hall of Famer, Mike DeVito.
All right. Thank you very much, John. Well done down there on the field. Well, the Black Bears get it done today with the win, improved to 1-1 on the season as Bryant falls to 1-1. Don't miss our next broadcast as Maine Hockey hosts UConn on October 6th at 7:30. Watch live on WVII, Fox 22 Bangor, WPNE Portland, and Fox College Sports. University of Maine Black Bear Football is a presentation of Learfield. For our producer, Jared Fieldson, and the PAC Network crew, for John Alba and my partner, Mike DeVito, I'm Dan Anakin. Again, the final score, Maine gets the win. Home opener, 60-12. So long from Orono.